Welcome back. It's Laurie from Cook Script Craft, and I am unboxing the bonus kits. As you can see, bonus kits from the March-April garden kit called A Rustic Spring from the International Scrapbook Garden. All of these are sold separately. They make great add-ons to the main A Rustic Spring kit, which I unboxed in a separate video, so make sure you go watch that to see what comes in that kit. But you can also just purchase each of these kits individually if you're just looking for some great paper that you want to add to your collection, some great mixed media elements or chipboard or flowers or what have you. So let's just get right into it and start opening up a couple of these elements. Let's start with the bonus paper flowers. Actually, this is part of the paper kit, which is really something different that is in the Rustic Spring kit. When you're getting the bonus paper, which I'll show you in a second, you're also going to get a couple embellishments with it. So let's hold off on that for a second. Let's start with the mixed media kit, which is really cool. It comes with a lot of fun stuff. You're getting some of my favorite new products, sprays. Shimmer Spritz in Plum Pudding, which is a purpley color. Now, I worked with vibes and colorings. I haven't worked with spritz colors before, so I don't know if they're like shiny or just like a matte type of color. This says it's an iridescent water-based spray. So I'm looking forward to using this color. I love the Shimmers products. And then you also get a Kaiser Craft Kaiser Mists. This is in Blackberry. And that one looks really pretty too. It's also iridescent. So very, very cool. Then you also get, this is awesome, some embossing powder in a really gorgeous kind of forest green color. I'm trying to look to see, oh, and it is called Forest. So I'm very excited to work with that. I actually got my heat embossing tool over Christmas, been itching to use it. I can't wait to use it with this product. We also have in the mixed media kit some Shimmers Inklings, which I have not worked with before, but I'm really excited because I've seen a lot of people using them on their scrapbook layouts and they look really cool. Steely Blue Eyes and Coral Reef. These are watercolors and you activate them, as it says on the package, by spritzing with water. So I am excited. This one comes from the Metal Collection, so I think it's gonna be more metallic. And this one says it's the Pearl Collection, so I think it's gonna be kind of like pearlescent, maybe a little shiny. They look really, really gorgeous. I like these colors a lot. And then the last thing in the mixed media bonus kit is the Prima Art Ingredients mica powder in Sunny Yellow. And what I think, I've never used the mica powder before, but I believe that you can kind of use it just like how you would use some of the other Prima Art Ingredients products. Mix it with other mediums to create fun textures and like with your stencils or what have you on your layout. So this is going to be a fun element to use to create some extra dimension and just some fun mixed media on this one. I like that. And I like the color too. It's really, really a nice color for spring without being too like bright and bold yellow. So I like that color a lot. So that's the mixed media kit. Because I can see it down here, we've got the the bonus chipboard kit, which has a lot of product from Creative Embellishments in it. And I love Creative Embellishments chipboard. We've got this, which looks like two stained glass window pieces, kind of perfect for Easter. We've got some really gorgeous like vine pieces, floral vine pieces. This one has some words in it, which I will open up, which will be great for creating some titles. Extra, oh cute, bunny, I love it. Oops, this one says hunt, okay, for your, you know, egg hunts. Special, egg, and oh, I think the last one in here is Easter. So you could make a whole big title and do like Easter egg hunt, and these are really easy to, you know, paint or add some coloring to. I've actually done some of these chipboard and sprayed them with misting spray, and they really take the color really well if you don't want them to be just the regular natural chipboard color. So I'll put those over here. We've got a lovely egg-shaped frame, which is really nice. We also have a cool archway. That's really cool. And then a nice circle frame. I like that one a lot. That's really cool. So that's what comes in the bonus chipboard kit. Then we have, okay, I want to make sure I get all of this right, bonus embellies. So the bonus embellies kit, I have these labeled, thank goodness, bonus embellies part one. This looks like a sheet of, let's open this up, Bow Bunnies Back to Basics tags and cut-aparts. So these are sheets of cut-aparts, Bow Bunny, Hippity Hop, Cottontail. So from the Cottontail collection, some cut-apart pieces, really, really fun. Then you can add with Bonus and Bellies Part 2, it says. Glitter set from Prima. Look at those gorgeous colors. It's nice greens and pinks and purples. Oh, those are really lovely. Then you get these cool, this is Prima too, Say It in Pearls. I love those flourishes with the shiny little flowers. And this is nice too. This is actually like a stand, although it's flat on the back, so you could still adhere it to a page or not a toy, or a project. Maybe put it on a canvas, and then these are little signs that you could put on top. Memory Lane, Dream Garden, Heritage Road. This is really nice. Then we have some Prima flowers, which are not actually flowers. They're butterflies, but I love the way they look. Really, really gorgeous. And the butterflies go perfectly with some of the 49 in market papers that are in the main kit. Then we also have clear stamps from Kaiser Craft, which are really gorgeous because they've got the butterflies and that, what is that, fleur-de-lis pattern? It says, friendship is a flower. Thanks to you, I laugh a little harder, cry a little less, and smile a little more. Really nice. We have a 6x6 stencil from the Crafter's Workshop. Some flower patterns. Really pretty. You can use these for a lot of different things. And then a 49 and Market laser cut shapes. And I'm loving this little frame here. That's really cool. They've all been already like laser cut, so you just have to kind of punch them out, but they've got words and little butterflies. I love the honeycomb. You could actually like spray that and make a cool background pattern somehow with that, and then just save the chipboard piece and use that somehow, something else. It's like a 2-in-1, I think, with that. That's really nice. So those are our bonus embellishments. Put those back. Well, I will put them back in the bag later. Then we have, put this over here too. Then we have the bonus, the extra blooms. And this, I believe, is all 49 in market flowers. Yep, 49 in market. These are gorgeous. Look how shiny. Look how shiny and pink. Then we have some 49 in market in the purple, which I love that little like pan flute type thing. Those are so pretty. 49 in market vintage shades. Love that. Love these two. Such gorgeous colors on these. And then this one is really nice. It's much bigger than the rest. Very, very pretty. I love that color. So all 49 in market. These would be, it's a garden vine piece. These would be gorgeous to add. So just some extra dimension. If you really like using flowers, this is an awesome bonus kit to purchase. And then you have the bonus paper. Now this bonus paper kit comes with extra paper that is not included in the main kit, but it also comes with extra flowers, which is so awesome this time. None of the other bonus kits, I believe, have come with extra flowers. So you get some 49 in market red flowers, which these I think actually came in the fall kit too, which they're really gorgeous. And then you get some Prima flowers too, and I love those. They kind of have a shiny like felted feel to them. They're really cool. So let's look through the papers. These papers are all going to be Fab Scraps, 49 in market, and 13 Arts, but they are different than the ones in the main kit. I'm going to stress that. We've got some 13 Arts Vintage Moments. So these would be great for using as like a cut apart. This is a smaller sheet. Everything else is a 12 by 12, but I really like these. It's got some words on it. Have a magic of your own love and some nice little fun little tickets there. That's really cool. And then we have the 13 Arts, also from the Vintage Moments collection. This one is Lavender Fields. And it's got some pretty music notes and some lavender flowers there, and the back side, just a nice neutral kind of base, which I think is really pretty. But I do like the flowers on that side. And then also from Vintage Moments, you have more of the clocks, some of the lavender flowers. This is called In the Past. And then, ooh, this side is really cool with the clocks. I love that contrast between the whites and like the blacks. I like that side. Then we're getting into, I think this is a 49 in Market page. This is the back side, and you've got flowers on this side. Yeah, this is Tattered Garden, Tattered Playground. So this side is more of like a neutral, though you do have some words here over here with like some splatters. Sorry for the out of focus a little bit. And then this side is the back side. So let's see what this is. This is the Tattered Leaves, part of the Tattered Garden collection. So let's see if we can focus in on those leaves a little bit. There they are. That's a really cool pattern. You almost don't want to cover that up with photos or anything else. I really like that. That's right in the center. And then the back side has some flowers down here. A nice little pattern on the branding strip. Put that over here. And then there are two pages from Fab Scraps. I love the red roses on here with the little butterflies. This is the Roses Are Red page. And then we have a nice kind of weave pattern on the other side. That's really cool. And then the last page also has some roses within a little chair and a teacup. This is called Love Grows Here. And then just a nice little kind of whitewashed backpack pattern on the back side. So those are all the bonus papers that come in the kit, and those are all the bonus kits. You can go to the International Scrapbook Garden website to purchase all of these bonus kits as well as the main kit, and all of the links are going to be below for where to go to purchase, as well as follow on social media and subscribe. Follow the blog. Can't wait to see what the rest of the design team is doing with all of these cool kits. This is the garden kit. There's also a tool shed kit that some of the other design team members are working with, so make sure you check that out too. And I'll see you guys next time.